She became a cultural phenomenon 20 years ago in Flashdance. Now she's in the Showtime hit lesbian drama, The L Word. Please welcome Jennifer Beals. Good to see you. Oh,
this is so cozy.
Isn't it cozy?
Yes.
It is. Nice. So last time I saw you, wow, you looked stunning at that party.
Oh, thank you. It only took about 3 hours.
Excuse me, just look at this. You look absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
That was at the InStyle Oscar party.
Right. That was the InStyle party. It was a Colette Dunigan dress. From Australia.
Divine.
I was so excited to meet you. My husband and I kept going, there's Sharon and Ozzy. Let's go say hi. Like, oh, you go over. It was really exciting. I was really happy to meet you.
No, it was so good to meet you. And then I came back here and told everyone on the show.
Oh, did you?
Sweet. Yes. Since Flashdance, you have been such a fashion icon. And in the new show, L Word, you look amazing.
That's very sweet of you to say. I don't feel like a fashion icon at all. I mean, first of all, the sweatshirt in Flashdance was a total accident. I had a sweatshirt and I put it in the dryer for too long and I couldn't get my head through the hole, so I cut out the hole. And most of the time, I'm in True Religion jeans and concert t-shirts, you know, Aerosmith t-shirts or Bruce Springsteen t-shirts and cowboy boots. That's really most of the time what I wear. And then I get dressed up when I
do shows.
Leave the house.
And you look stunning.
Thank you.
That, who would have thought that sweatshirt and Flashdance would have, like, made such an impact that it did?
I know. Who would have thought a laundry mistake would
make such an impact? Then everyone was out cutting their tops. But I have something for you because I know you like Aerosmith.
Oh, my God.
So this goes for your collection because
so
you like
fantastic t-shirts. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Because I heard that you love the way they dress.
I do. Well, I think my true fashion icons are Aerosmith and probably Babe Paley. Those were probably would have to be, you know, my favorites.
This is really very rock and roll.
Yes, very rock and roll.
Very rock.
Joe Perry with those canes alone is just too fantastic.
I know. Stunning.
It's really great. Makes me want to have a cane. When I get older and I have to have a cane, I'm going to have the most rocking canes
of
all time.
It looks very regal.
This is fantastic. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. So. Now, the L Word. What made you want to be a part of the cast?
Well, when
you weren't off put by the script?
By the subject? No,
yeah.
Not at all. I mean, to me, what was so interesting was this character, Bette Porter, who is really this sort of type A personality, very, very driven, very ambitious, and she seems like she has everything together, but yet she's so much more diffident and kind of shy in a way. And what was interesting is to see this character trying to balance her work life and her family life. And it's a big struggle.
Was it difficult to go and be passionate with another woman, the kissing and the touching?
Well, it was interesting because we...
Different.
It's different. It's much softer. And what's interesting about doing the love scenes that we have on The L Word is that everything is so choreographed that at a certain point, my scene partner, Laurel Holloman, who plays my partner in the show, she said, I feel like Fred Astaire. Because every single thing was choreographed. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as a cast, we, before we started the show, the director of the pilot, Rose Trochet, had given us this videotape of love scenes that she thought worked and some that didn't work. And she wanted us to watch this tape together as a cast. Mm-hmm. And when we watched it, it became very clear that a love scene didn't work when the actors were fearful. And we vowed to each other that we would commit ourselves fully to those scenes so that we wouldn't disrupt the storytelling. Because what happens is when you smell the fear coming off the actor, the story is interrupted and then it takes the audience out and it's no longer valid. So,
yeah.
So it was really interesting. That was an interesting night watching about, you know, 20 love scenes all put together.
And that works. No, that one doesn't work.
Oh, no. I'm not convinced. Holding the breath, that's not good.
Well,
that was funny.
We're going to go to a break now, but when we come back, we're going to hear more about the L word.
You are just so sweet.
Thank you. Seeing that you've had some amazing guests on the L Word.
Yes, we've been very lucky.
Snoop Dogg.
Yes, Snoop was on the show.
And how was he to work with?
Very charming, very, very charming man. And he doesn't have a huge, you know, entourage. He had one very large bodyguard who was very sweet, but he was afraid of my dog. It was the funniest thing. I'm a very sweet chocolate lab terrier cross. And I would come up just to go over and say hello. I don't know, maybe it was the dog smelt the food and
yeah. He
got a little afraid of the dog. But Snoop was very, very sweet. Very, very sweet. And very easy to work with.
Did he come with his... Last time I saw him, I think he was dressed as a pixie. He was all in green and he had like this big rhinestone chalice and he had a cane too.
Oh, did he?
Yes,
no,
he did.
No, he wasn't all dressed up. I mean, he got dressed up for the character, mm-hmm. but he wasn't all dressed up. But his trailer was opposite mine and sometimes when the guys would walk past my trailer, they, you know, they had these really deep voices, and the dogs would hear these deep voices, and they start barking like crazy. That's probably why the bodyguard was a little afraid. But the dog wouldn't do anything. Promise.
A little lap dog, and he's like...
Yeah.
So who would you like on the show to guest star?
Oh, my gosh. I have a very long list.
Come on.
I'd like the entire cast of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, because I'm obsessed with the show. I would like Jennifer Tilly and Cheetah Rivera and Ernest Borgnine and Elizabeth Taylor as a very wealthy couple who are, you know, collecting art pieces.
Yeah.
I think that would be good. I think that's a good group. And you, of course.
Well, when I was at the GLAAD Awards about a week ago, they were auctioning off things, and I bought a walk-on.
Oh, fantastic!
I did, with my friend, Rob Eric. He and I are going to be coming on for a walk-on together.
God,
I know.
That was fantastic.
Yeah.
Do you know who you're supposed to play?
No.
Can you dictate it? Can't you say, like, you're my friend or something?
I could.
I think you should. I think you should have it in your contract. I think you should call your lawyer.
Say I have to be Jennifer's friend, otherwise I am not coming. I shall definitely throw a tantrum.
And organize so that you can have your dogs in the trailer.
Yeah, I will. I'll bring them.
Okay.
I'll bring them up. Definitely.
Very
so
good.
I'm so excited about that.
Yes,
and
I'm
you,
excited about it too.
You start back in June?
Yes, we start back in June.
Yeah, very excited.
It'll be about 6 months or so.
Now, when I was at the GLAAD Awards, I mean... By the gay community, they have just embraced this show.
Yes, they have. We've been very, very fortunate. It's really lovely. I mean, we've gotten great response from the gay community.
Isn't this the first show that is based around lesbians?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, on TV. It's amazing that it's taken this long.
I know, it's interesting. It's so funny, when I was reading the script, that didn't occur to me at all. What I saw were these amazing characters and the sort of universality of these stories about love and loneliness mm-hmm. and ambition and family. And that, to me, is what was so interesting. And
yeah.
I think that's really why the show is so successful, is because so many people can relate to the show.
Of course. Now, tell me, what is your opinion on gay marriage?
I think that it's really an extension of the civil rights movement. And... You know, coming from an interracial marriage, being the child of an interracial relationship, I realized that had I been born, or had my parents gotten together in, say, 1940, they wouldn't have been able to get married. And I think about, you know, all the children that are adopted by mm-hmm. gay couples, and I think, you know, they wouldn't have these homes. And I think that, really, at the end of the day, the law should treat everyone equally. And there are so many things that marriage gives to a couple in terms of the law. And I realize, though, at the other end of the spectrum, it's very hard for a lot of people to accept, because the word marriage carries with it so much weight. But I think at the end of the day, you need to be free to love who you want to love, and you need to have the law sanction your love. And there's no greater sanctity than love, and I think that what pleases God the most is love between two people.
That's very true. We're about to see a clip of you and the L Word. Oh. What's the clip that we're going to see?
Well, Bette Porter, my character, is the director of an art museum, and the show that she has put on at the museum is very challenging, and a very misbehaving right-wing group is starting to attack her personally based on her sexual orientation.
Okay, let's have a look.
Excuse me. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Telling people the truth?
You shut that off. You have no right. You shut it off.
That stuff you're showing in your museum, it's pornography, it's filth.
This is my home.
Disgusting.
This is my family.
You have no right to show it there.
You have no right to come here.
You have no right to corrupt children.
Don't take this back to Faye Buckley. You tell her, if she ever, ever try something like this again, she will regret it. Shut that off.
You're going to hell.
It makes me cry sometimes.
I know. It makes you go, ooh, how dare they do that?
Yeah,
you know,
I know,
it pulls
very,
you in.
It was a fun thing to do because you know you're not going to get hurt. You know, it's fun.
You can let it all go.
Yes, yeah. You can be heroic and let it go.
I'm so glad that you came in to talk
so
to me today.
Glad.
I'm so glad, and I can't wait to come on to the show with you. I'm really excited. Now, you can catch Jennifer on The L Word, and it airs Sunday nights on Showtime.